It seems like Nvidia was so close this time they almost had a reasonable RTX 50 series GPU. Welcome to my video on the RTX 5070 Ti. Once again, I'm making an alternative launch day video with some slightly different content than usual. If you want to know why, you might have seen my video earlier today where I talked about this only arriving within the last 24 hours, which is not enough time to do a full review. But since a lot of you guys enjoyed my RTX 5090 review roundup, as well as my RTX 5080 generational uplift video, I thought for the 5070 Ti, ¿por qué no los dos?
Excellent!
Today's video is brought to you by the Paul's Hardware Store on paulshardware.net, the only official source for Paul's Hardware merchandise. Tantalizing t-shirts, brilliant beer sets, high-quality hoodies, and more, all featuring the classic thumbscrew for tasteful and refined viewers, or the 8-bit thumbscrew for tasteful and refined viewers who hate curves. New designs are added sporadically and at random, so head over to paulshardware.net and get some of that sweet, sweet merch right now. Or not right now, after you watch the video. Either way. So one thing that I do really like about launch days still, despite so many of the things that I used to like about them not being things anymore, thanks to pricing being out of control and a general lack of enthusiasm as a result of those really crazy prices. But I do still like how when a new GPU launches, there's gonna be a bunch of reviews that go up, and you can check out a wide variety of them in order to get sort of a broad assessment of the new product from a bunch of different sources. And the reviews that I've selected today are all from sources that I trust. We have Hardware Unboxed, GamersNexus, Optimum, Linus Tech Tips, Derbauer, and JayzTwoCents, and all of their videos are linked in the description. If you haven't watched them yet, I recommend checking them out if you want a lot more detail than what I'm gonna go over today. But the too long didn't watch summary is, if the 5070 Ti was actually its base MSRP price of $750 as promised, it would be a reasonable price to performance offering given current pricing and availability, because there are no other cards to even buy in this price range right now, especially if you're in the US. They're all sold out. Now those are already some pretty serious caveats, because if there are no other alternative GPUs to buy, then we are simply at the mercy of Nvidia, add-in board partners, and retailers to sell these cards for a reasonable price. But we all already know that that's just not gonna happen. When demand is high and supply is low, the people who are in charge of the supply are gonna try to make as much profit as possible in that situation. And hence, while there are a handful of supposedly MSRP RTX 5070 Ti's, like this Asus Prime model, which is not overclocked, but the assumption that I and many others are making is that these MSRP cards are gonna be extremely scarce, and chances are what you'll actually see available at retail, if any are available at all, will be the cards that cost $900 plus. Part of the reason for that is that while we have seen a few listings at $750 for these cards, there's a big gap between those and the next tier up. Those all just seem to start at $900, which is a very big jump from the base price. But as long as you are aware that that $750 promise is probably going to be broken, we can proceed and talk about other things, like the actual performance of the card, which is not horrible. And that's not necessarily a ringing endorsement, but it kind of is given the current state of Nvidia GPU launches lately, especially with the RTX 50 series. The 5070 Ti performs about the same as a 4080 or a 4080 Super, and those cards cost $1,000. So does that mean $1,000 is reasonable for the 5070 Ti? Well, Nvidia seems to think so, and probably the scalpers out there are gonna be thinking so as well, as I'm not gonna be too surprised if we see these jump up well above $1,000, at least in the few days after launch, or until Nvidia can get more units onto store shelves, and we don't know how long that's gonna take. Still, Nvidia was on the verge of the reviews for the 5070 Ti not being terrible, but unfortunately the generational performance uplift, as we'll look at in just a moment, is pretty stagnant once again, given that the 5070 Ti is typically a few frames behind a 4080 or a 4080 Super. So all of the reviews are pretty much saying the same thing. Do not buy this GPU, particularly if it costs $1,000 plus. But as a follow-up prediction, I will say, once again, none of the reviewers' advice is going to matter, because these are going to sell out anyway. Okay, let's take a look at some more specific data from the review roundup. The overall conclusion is that the RTX 5070 Ti, when compared to last generation, and you might be comparing it to the 4070 Ti or the 4070 Ti Super, is that you're gonna see about a 7 to 20% raw performance boost over the RTX 4070 Ti Super, or more like a 15 to 20% boost versus the 4070 Ti non-Super, because the 4070 Ti has really not been available since the 4070 Ti Super came out. And I guess you could say that about the 4070 Ti Super relative to the 5070 Ti as well, because Nvidia just likes replacing cards rather than having more than one in the same category on the market at the same time. Now, also contributing to the reviews being not as terrible this time around is that comparisons to the 40 series and older generations is not quite as disappointing compared to the recent reviews of the 5080 and 5090. And on the plus side, efficiency is actually looking quite good too. That has been a strong point for Nvidia for some time now, with typical draw for the 5070 Ti being below 300 watts, resulting in some nice cool running temperatures. Performance per watt is also a strong point, as GamersNexus pointed out, particularly when compared to AMD's 7900 series GPUs. What reviews have really struggled to address is how things will look tomorrow, though, when 5070 Ti GPUs go up for sale. We've been pitched a $750 base MSRP, but early listings, as previously mentioned, are already jumping that price up to $900 at minimum, with some already going for $1,000 or more, and a 5070 Ti is just not worth $1,000, even if MSI throws a lucky figure into the box for the first run of sales. Despite anticipating that prices will be exorbitantly high though, given the extremely limited available of the 5080 and 5090 at launch, we're not optimistic that the 5070 Ti will suddenly just have way more GPUs in stock versus the other cards, and it's very likely that there will only be a handful of these $750 models that are actually sold. And for some of them, like Newegg, might force you to buy a whole combo in order to get the card that you actually want, and that of course is just due to the limited availability and the high demand right now. And in case I didn't point it out, there is no Founders Edition for the 5070 Ti. I am anticipating that most board partners like Asus, Gigabyte, MSI, and so on will opt to drop their allocated 5070 Ti dies into OC models that sell for 20-30% or more over the $750 MSRP, which makes it very hard to assess real-world pricing, resulting in the double conclusion that most reviews have used to sum up the 5070 Ti. At MSRP, it's not a horrible value. And again, that's tantamount to a ringing endorsement given the current GPU climate. Even with updated retail pricing, it's still hanging out with the 4070 Super and the 7800 XT, which were both among the best options for bang for the buck in the mid-range for the past year or so. But when you ratchet that price up to $900 or more, the cost per frame jumps by about $150, and the 5070 Ti joins this group of extremely poor value cards at closer to $12 per frame. And remember, even this top group up here with the 4070 Super and the 7800 XT isn't the best in terms of value. What we really want from a new generation of GPUs is a significant increase in value versus last gen, not just cozying right up to it and hoping things will be fine for another couple years. Next up, we're gonna take a look at a chart that I put together showing the generational uplift of 70 Ti class cards. Since there isn't always a 70 Ti class card in each generation, I'm sometimes using Ti, I'm sometimes using Super, or in the case of the 900 series, I'm just using the base 970. So starting with that top row, GTX 970, which had an MSRP of $330, wasn't that nice. The 970 was an exceptional value, even with the 3.5 gig VRAM scandal, if you guys remember that. But along with the card's MSRP and launch date, we're going back about 10 plus years, I have the two generations old card, which would be a 70 class or a 70 Ti class if available. We can see that the 970 was 62% faster than the 670. I have a comparison to the last generation 70 class card, the GTX 770 in this case, and the 970 was 43% faster than that card. And then where applicable, I'll list the last gen Ti or Super card, the performance increase there. And then the last gen flagship, which was the 780 Ti in this case, the 970 was about 3% slower than that card, but do note that that's a 970, not a Ti or a Super. Next we have the 1070. The 1070 Ti launched for $400 in November 2017. And note that the Ti or Super cards will often launch significantly later than the original cards that launch in that generation. Like the 1070 actually launched in 2016, and the 1070 Ti didn't come around for about a year after that. Still, it was a 136% improvement over the two gens old 770, a 66% improvement over the last gen 970. There was not a 970 Ti or Super, but there was a 980 Ti, and the 1070 Ti was 26% faster than that card. Imagine if the 5070 Ti was 26% faster than the 4090. Wouldn't that be cool? That'd almost be like what Jensen promised the 5070 performance would be like at the CES keynote, but he was talking about multi-frame generation, which was a bunch of bullshit. Anyway, that's clearly a high watermark, and Nvidia wised up after that with the 20 series. We have the 2070 Super, which launched in July 2019 for $500. And yes, again, this was about a year after the original RTX 20 series launched out with the non-super cards. Still, 2070 Super was 122% faster than the 970, 52% faster than the 1070, 34% faster than the 1070 Ti, and right about on par with the 1080 Ti, coming in at 1% faster. And you will note that the pricing has been steadily increasing. Next, we have the RTX 30 series with the 3070 Ti, which launched in May 2021 for $600. That increase in price was the main complaint about the 3070 Ti. It was 94% faster than the 1070 Ti, 64% faster than the 2070, and 45% faster than the 2070 Super, while also maintaining a 12% lead over the 2080 Ti. And that leads us to the 40 series. I have the RTX 4070 Ti and the 4070 Ti Super both listed here. Though their launches were separated by about a year, they came in at the same $800 price, and since they were never really both available widely at the same time, I decided to put them both on the chart so we can see the differences between the two. The 4070 Ti Super, despite its redundant name, did provide us with more performance for the same price just about a year later, 125% faster than the 2070 Super, 66% faster than the 3070, and 55% faster than the 3070 Ti, while coming in just shy of the 3090 Ti at -3%. And that brings us to today's launch, the RTX 5070 Ti. And when I did the 5080 with this same formatted chart, it was pretty glaring how much of a drop-off in relative performance the 5080 was offering versus prior 80 class cards. The 5070 Ti doesn't look quite so bad in this format. In fact, the percentage increase versus two gens old is 138%. Percentage increase versus last gen is 55%. And that's pretty much in the same range versus the previous generations. Compared to the 4070 Ti Super though, we're only at 11% increase, and versus the 4090 we're at -28%, and that is also a disappointing result. As we can see, in previous generations we were able to get pretty close with the 70 Ti class card, sometimes outperforming the last gen flagship, sometimes being within 5 or 10%, but clearly not the generational uplift that we have enjoyed in the past. And as I mentioned also in the video I posted earlier today, there are various reasons why the pricing is so horrible, but a big reason is that these Blackwell GPUs are still built on TSMC's 4N process, which is why Nvidia had to stop production of the 40 series cards in order to switch over production to the 50 series cards. And they could have mitigated this situation, I think, if they had made some accommodations for consumers out there, simply by waiting until more GPUs were produced and more stock was available, or simply by allowing more inventory overlap from the 40 series to the 50 series. But it seems like what they were actually trying to do was use up all that 40 series inventory before the 50 series launched, and now you have a situation where there's no cards on the market and scalpers are just having a field day. For all these reasons, it's very difficult to properly review the 5070 Ti right now, and we probably won't have a good understanding until the dust clears and we're at least a couple weeks out from launch and we see how quickly restocks are coming into play at retailers. I still very much believe that next generation GPUs should significantly improve performance per dollar. Nvidia really seems to not want to do that lately. The 5070 Ti would at least be reasonable or not awful if stock was available and they could actually be purchased for $750. But for now, the 5070 Ti is basically just another RTX 4080 or 4080 Super, maybe 1 or 2% slower. It's gonna sell for the same street price, around $1,000, with very similar performance. And what else is there to say? I guess we can hold out hope that these 12V2x6 connectors are less likely to melt on a 5070 Ti due to it being a lower wattage card, but man, that's a pretty thin silver lining if you ask me. But that is my review recap and a bit of a historical look at the 5070 Ti class cards from Nvidia, where we can see that gamers aren't really being given a lot to be excited about with this newest generation. And I think a lot of the blame lies with Nvidia. I'd say most of the blame, but we can also blame the retailers and add-in board partners for taking advantage of the pricing situation as much as they can right now as well. But guys, if you enjoyed this video, consider hitting the thumbs up button, and in the description down below you can find links to all of the reviews that I used to do this review roundup, and you can also find a link to my store at paulshardware.net where you can buy some merchandise to help support my channel and get yourself some high quality merchandise. That's all for this one. Thanks again. We'll see you in the next video.